It seems like the world has stopped. Empty airplanes, deserted highways, but emissions?
So this year, carbon emissions aren't expected to drop that much.
That's my coworker, Grist reporter Shannon Osaka. She's been looking into how the COVID-19 pandemic has impacted global emissions. And together, we're going to explain the relationship between carbon emissions and coronavirus with this bucket. The water inside represents all the CO2 in our atmosphere. The drain is the ability of the earth and ocean to remove excess CO2 from the air. And the flow from these spigots right here are all the emissions, cars, power plants, smokestacks, that we're currently pumping into the atmosphere. This huge problem we have, climate change, is because we're adding CO2 at roughly twice the rate with which it can absorb into the earth or ocean.
So carbon emissions come from three main sectors. There's electricity generation and heat, there's transportation, and there's manufacturing. And then there's a lot of different smaller places as well. So while the pandemic has affected basically every part of our lives, the only meaningful decrease in emissions has come from transportation. We've turned that down by about half. But at the same time, we still use energy to keep the lights on, to heat our homes. Now, as restrictions are starting to lift, we're slowly turning that transportation spigot back up. Depending on how fast we get back to normal, we're expecting emissions this year to go down by about 4% to 8%.
But 2020's contributions are just a drop in the bucket when it comes to climate change. You have to look at the big picture. We're living with levels of CO2 that haven't been seen in 3 million years, back when there were trees in the South Pole. We've been warming the planet for over a century. Lowering emissions for 1 year doesn't change things that much. In order to avoid the worst consequences of climate change, we need to think about the whole bucket. That means making drastic cuts to carbon emissions every single year. We can all agree that pandemics are one of the worst ways to make that happen. Loss of life and deep suffering all for a small change that won't last. To create a positive, lasting impact, we still need to figure out how to reduce emissions across the board. We also need to increase the flow down the drain and, hey, maybe find new ways to remove CO2 from the atmosphere. Solving climate change is a big job. It's going to take more than temporarily sheltering in place to make that happen.